My first question is, what is your opinion about machine intelligence research and its application potential?
Well, machine intelligence research, sometimes in the United States we call it the area of intelligent systems, is a kind of special branch, I believe, of artificial intelligence, which is devoted to developing machines which would perform very complex tasks in an intelligent but human-like way. In other words, they are trying to perform these operations in the way in which human beings are doing that. The traditional artificial intelligence didn't care about how it is done. It was basically viewed as, doing something on the computer, no matter how, which would somehow be similar to what is accomplished by humans. But in machine intelligence, the important point is that they want to study how human beings are doing that, and therefore it is very, very different. This human-like is taken very seriously. So in that sense, this requires, of course, new challenges, because, for example, the classical mathematics and the classical logic, two-valued logic, is not sufficient for that. Mm-hmm. Because here the human beings do not work with precise categories, they do not work with precise measurements and so forth, as was emphasized by Professor Zade in his introductory speech. But they are basically working, they are reasoning and acting upon perceptions. Now, perceptions can be approximated pretty well by natural language. Mm-hmm. So there is a kind of a sequence of starting with perceptions, then approximating the perceptions in natural language, but that still, natural language cannot be pretty well expressed in terms of classical mathematics and classical logic. So then we have a new tool, of course, fuzzy logic and various uncertainty theories which can do that, which can approximate natural language, not completely represent it, but approximate natural language, and then we can use these representations to actually perform these tasks, to do the reasoning, decision making, and whatever is needed for performing these tasks. So I think this is a totally new kind of direction, very different from the traditional one, and the potential is tremendous, of course. It's tremendous because the classical area cannot handle this human-like kind of things. We cannot, at this point, we still cannot design a machine which would automatically park the car or which would drive the car in a heavy traffic of a city and things like that. We cannot do that. But hopefully, with using the perceptions, being able to actually process, reason with perceptions and propositions in natural language, eventually this will be possible. So there are many, many applications, of course, which were covered at this conference. Mm-hmm. I mean, so I cannot go to all the application areas, but the potential is tremendous. It's just mm-hmm. a very new area, very significant area, and very different from the traditional one. I would call it even like a very new grand paradigm shift, mm-hmm. In science and engineering.
What do you think, what is the most important aspect of these technologies for industrial applications or real-world applications?
Well, I believe that it is the transition from what is called the hard computing to what we call now soft computing. Now, soft computing is a kind of partnership of a number of technologies. They are all kind of emerging technologies, primarily starting with the 80s, more or less. And they include like fuzzy logic, of course, that's very important, fuzzy logic, fuzzy set theory. They include neural networks. Mm-hmm. They include evolutionary programming and genetic algorithms and all that area. Then you have other areas like reasoning with imprecise probabilities, and this is connected with various theories of uncertainty, the issue of how to measure uncertainty and how to utilize various important principles of uncertainty. Then you have, of course, other formalized languages like rough set theory, etc. So there's a whole category of tools, relatively new tools, which has developed, well, we can say, during the last half of the 20th century, but more closer to the end of the century. And they are now integrated under the umbrella term soft computing, and they are used together. They are kind of hybrid system. They are used, you know, opportunistically according to what we need in each particular application context. Mm-hmm. But I think that the soft computing is the dominating aspect, if you want, of this machine intelligence, or we used to call it also intelligent systems area.
Do you believe that artificial brain will be created?
Well, this is a very difficult question. I am by nature an optimist, and I think that in principle I don't see any reason why it could not be, but this is just a speculation, and in some sense there might be some inherent difficulty. And the difficulty might be that there will be always kind of a residuum which we could not properly understand and properly represent, mm-hmm. some residuum. Like, for example, we are natural language. We look at natural language. Human beings communicate via natural language. Now, we try to develop various new formalized languages by which we can represent better and better, in a better and better way, natural language, and that, you know, starting with classical two-valued logic, that's very, very bad for representing natural language. But we then have multi-valued logic, then we have modal logics, and we have now fuzzy logic, and so forth. So we are trying to have a better and better representation of natural language, but the question is whether we can represent it fully. Always there is some kind of gap, and that's a very interesting speculative question whether such a gap can be closed or never closed. If we can never close it, then actually there's something which is remaining there which we never be able to do. I'm optimist, meaning that I would not say no, it's impossible, but I am, at the same time, I am doubtful somewhat that there is some kind of residuum which cannot be sort of bridged. Mm-hmm.